All right, LC3 children, if you want to come on up, please, and we're going to get in our three circles. Welcome and greetings. This is LC3, we call it. The Lookout Children's Community Chorus is going to be doing a little bit of a prelude. And we meet twice a week over at Fairland Elementary School, and this is a bit of a hybrid chorus. These are public school kids in the after-school program, as well as homeschool kids, and we gather twice a week to practice. And we teach music, movement, and how to listen, and how to be a good neighbor. And so this first piece that we're going to sing is Hashivenu. It's a lament from Lamentations. It's actually in Hebrew. And we'll sing it through, and then we'll do it in canon. So here, this is Hashivenu. Sounds like it would be just an easy thing, but it really actually isn't. And so even for these young children to learn how to watch me as the director and also do their job while they hear other sounds is quite an extraordinary feat. This next one is a setting of a Mark Twain text. he was known to have said, "My mama had a great deal of trouble with me, but I think she enjoyed it." And so I thought this was a great song for me to learn anyway. And they're going to start off with the three parts all together, and then they're going to divide into three parts and then come back together. And again, this is "My Mama Had a Great Deal of Trouble with Me." Attempt a next to impossible feat in front of your eyes tonight. We're going to do square dancing while singing on this stage. One of the beautiful things about music in many other cultures than our own is they don't have different words for dance versus beauty versus music. It's just all one word. And so one of the things that we do over at LC3 is help put that back together again. Because we're embodied souls, right? We're whole people. And the other thing that's really beautiful, as you look across the room tonight, is you see generations upon generations. And this is really important for God's people to come together and to celebrate His goodness, even while moving around. So this is "O Susanna," and we're going to attempt to do all this coordinatively.
Oh, have chosen to join us for our Spring Festival concert here at Covenant College. Delighted that you're here. If you would take a moment before we begin to silence any electronic devices that might distract us before, we appreciate that. If you're unfamiliar with our chapel, you can find drinking fountains and restrooms either by going out left down the stairs or by hanging a right and following this hallway around toward the backstage area. You'll notice that this program has been very intentionally titled a festival, which means that in addition to our college's choral ensembles, you'll hear from some of our special guests, the Lookout Mountain Presbyterian Church Chancel Choir, our brass ensemble, our jazz band, and the wonderful young people from whom you just heard, the Lookout Children's Community Chorus. In terms of programming, you'll notice I've been instructed to let you know during the jazz ensemble's first set, we will be featuring some dancers. They want to let me know that they will be making use of the aisles, so you may want to take care to avoid being stepped on. Also, to maximize our time together this evening, you'll notice that our ensembles will transition during the final selections from the prior ensemble, and your attentiveness will be greatly appreciated in assisting us in this venture. Before we hear from our chorale, will you please join me in a word of prayer? Please bow with me. Our great God and eternal Savior, we proclaim you this evening as worthy of all of our praises, for you are gracious and you are glorious. And so we pray, Lord, that you would indeed accept our praises this evening, both from those who are making music for us and for your glory, and as well as from those of us who are listening. We are grateful, Lord, for the gift of this evening, for the time we have here together. We thank you for the gift of music, and for the talents with which you have blessed your servants who will appear on the stage. We ask, Lord, that you would bless them and strengthen them as they present those gifts to you and to us. We ask, Lord, for your blessing on us as listeners, that you grant us attentive hearts and minds. Lord, we pray that you would be magnified in this hour. Indeed, to you alone be all glory. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
The mountain shake in the heart of the sea. It was good for the Hebrew children. It's good enough. Jameson Snuggs and Nabil Ian soloists on that tune called 4-on-6. Okay, at the beginning of the semester, Prescott asked me, told me that we should do this next tune, and it's a song from a musical that's been very big this year, and it's a movie called La La Land. So we're doing the tune called Lovely Night, and we're going to have Jessica and Mark dancing for us. This doesn't mean you have to go see the movie, because what we're doing now is just as good.
Stretches to the sea. We've stumbled on a view that's tailor-made for two. What a shame those two are, you and me. Some other girl and guy would love this swirling sky, but there's only you and I, and we've got shot, 'cause this could never be. You're not the type for me, and there's not a spark in sight. What a waste of a lovely night.
Thank you.
Who are to the Savior forever. Thank you.
Shelby Doctor. Prescott on bass. For our last jazz selection, we're going to play a tune that I actually heard played by Weather Report in Pittsburgh in 1973. And it was an amazing event that I experienced, and now we're going to play it for you because it's one of the best songs ever written. Yes, it is. It's called Birdland, otherwise known as Birdhouse. And Land of Birds.
Sarah Bess on set.
Thank you. Swiftly through the waters to the city far.
This next piece is entitled My Prayer, and some of you might think, well, it seems like you all did that 2 years ago. Why are you doing it again? Is it because it's your piece? I'm not exactly sure that that's the case. The seniors came to me and said, can we sing your piece again, Dr. Finch? And so that's why we're doing it tonight. One of the interesting things about My Prayer is that it's written for two different choirs. You have a main choir, and then you have the choir that will be up here, the antiphonal choir. And you will hear that there's this plea from Psalm 86. Hear my prayer, O Lord, for you are good, you're merciful, and I'm full of need. And then you're going to start hearing a prayer from heaven start to emerge. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Which is then going to move into Agnus Dei qui tollis peccata. Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. This all erupts in this great cascade of sound. And then we're left with Dona Nobis Pacem, grant us peace. Some of my colleagues have asked me, well, Scott, when are you going to get this piece published? Well, it's not for lack of trying, but guess what? The reason that it doesn't get published is because it's got this word in it, this really bad word in it. You ready for this bad word? Submit. That's what the publisher told me. It has the word submit in it. So when it comes to trusting, we must submit. And when we submit, freedom is ours. And hopefully you hear that in this piece. I'm not going to change the word, so it may not get published, because it's actually in Psalm 86. We hope you enjoy. Hear my prayer, O Lord.
Hear my prayer, O Lord.
So in just a moment, we'd like to invite the LC3 children up for our mighty conclusion. This is God's good gift to us as his people, to be able to respond to him in song. I think it's one of the leading antidotes for fear. I see we see that in the psalmist. I'm telling his own heart, why so downcast, O my soul? Trust in the Lord. This last piece is from Kenya. It's entitled Jambo, which means hello. It's such a great way of saying hello. Come on up, LC3 children, to the stage. And you also hear a statement in here called Hakuna Matata, which Disney does not own. It means no worries, for sure. But the question is, what is the root of our no worries? This piece brings out the idea that it's because we're welcomed that we have no worries. We have an embrace that is eternal. And so you're going to see the little children start off with the ladies, and they're going to sing the lead stanza, and then you'll see us dance. We move because our God moves. He moves in history. He moves in the midst of his people. And then you're going to see them pick their favorite animal, and they're going to act it out for you. Because all of this creation is our Father's world. And so we take delight in celebrating and hope that you have been able to celebrate with us by faith tonight and that you go home encouraged. Thank you for being here tonight. This is Jambo.
Jumbo!
We'll get the children out in the foyer in just a moment. Good night.